This video will cover Houdini's UV layout tool. We're going to start with an object in our scene. We'll turn on visibility and double-click to go inside. Let's drop down a UV layout node. Click on the output, hit the tab key and start typing UV layout, and hit enter. Turn on visibility for it, and hit Ctrl+4 to get the side-by-side windows. Spacebar B to expand the window. And you can see that everything is packed into a single tile, which is what the default setting is. This object has UVs, but they're not laid out yet, so we can let Houdini calculate the optimal layout for our UVs. Change the packing method to fixed scale. Depending on your needs, you can change the scale values to generate the number of UV tiles you want. And you can enable padding to tile boundaries. Let's change the value to 20. And we'll take a closer look, and then go back up to object level. Now we'll turn off visibility for the transit, and look at the second object. If we put the visibility flag to the UV quick shade, we'll see that our plane already has its UVs laid out. Let's hit Ctrl+4 to get the side-by-side view again. And we're going to hit Spacebar+5 to get the UV viewport. Hit Spacebar+B to expand the UV window. And we're going to drop down a UV layout node. Hit Tab and then type UV layout and select it. Move the visibility flag to the UV layout node. And again in the UV layout node, all our UVs have been packed into a single tile, which is the default setting. We can either use the existing UV data, or we can let Houdini repack our UVs again. We can change the scale value to change the number of UV tiles generated. And let's just turn on padding for the tile boundaries. And we have 3 tiles. As you can see, it just depends on the specific requirements you need for your work, and you can adjust the settings accordingly. These are just some of the packing methods in the UV layout node. We will cover other packing methods in future videos.